Knowing how much longer we will be able to drive our car before we need to stop for a recharge depends on accurate estimation of the battery SoC. This is of great importance, and it is much more challenging than in the case of conventional vehicle fuel gauge design, where the measurement is direct. In battery systems, we do not measure state of charge, which is not directly measurable. We actually measure something else and hopefully relate that to the SoC. The third subsystem contains three different methods for state of charge estimation. In practice, the BMS developer would only use one of them, but here we present all three to illustrate their individual merits and limitations. The first method, known as Coulomb counting, consists of integrating the current that enters and leaves the cell to keep track of the state of charge over time. A benefit of this method is its simplicity and very low computational cost. Its drawbacks include the accumulation of current sensor error and its inability to recover from a wrong initial condition because of the lack of feedback from voltage measurements. The second and third SoC estimation methods implemented here are the unscented and extended Kalman filters. Both are variations of nonlinear Kalman filters, and they rely on a model of the unit cell to predict the terminal voltage resulting from a current stimulus, estimating the internal cell states, the SoC among them, by comparing this prediction against measurement of the terminal voltage. The choice between EKF and UKF is typically made based on the severity of the system's nonlinearity. In this case, the only nonlinearity present is given by the OCV-SoC relationship, and it is a mild one, so it is expected that the EKF should give adequate results. The Kalman filter algorithm has two parts, the state update and the measurement update. The state update predicts the current state based on the previous state value and the input, and the measurement update corrects this prediction using newly acquired data. The cell model we use is implemented here as a MATLAB script and corresponds to the equivalent circuit we use to simulate the battery pack.